Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome to day 5 of ASD App Store domination. So let's get to work. Okay, in today's episode we are going to talk about GitHub. Now, GitHub is where you can safely store your project. Let's say your computer burns down or you just simply lost your files or your computer, then you can always fetch it from GitHub. And besides this, one major aspect of using GitHub, and I highly recommend that you do so, is version control. So you may have one version or maybe two versions of a project. Maybe you want to add a new feature and you want to test it out, but you want to leave the master version intact, and then you want to create a new branch and experiment on that one. So today I'm going to show you how to do just that. So first things first, you need to go to github.com and sign up, and you can sign up for free. And you can have public repositories, because a repository is what it is called when you upload one of your projects. So you can do that, of course, inside Xcode. So that is how we are going to do it. We have taken a look at how we upload it to GitHub, our Xcode project, our ASD magic project onto GitHub. And as you can see, it is already here. Okay, now. What is up next? Well, first of all, you need to sign up and have a GitHub repository. Next step is that you, let me just go here and open up our Xcode project. Well, here we have our Xcode project already implemented. Now, first, you need to link your Xcode project with GitHub, and to do that, go to preferences, I believe, and here you have accounts. Okay, now here, as you can see, we have our source control accounts, and to add one of your source control accounts, and you just need to add this plus button and select GitHub, of course. Click on continue, add your account and password, go ahead and fill them out. And after that, you need to go and, as I showed you earlier in an earlier episode, you need to go to remote, right click on it and create ASD magic remote on GitHub and add your credentials there if they are asked. And that is all you need to do. Now, then you already have GitHub repository for your project. And one last thing, if you haven't already checked that check mark when you create your project to create a GitHub repository, then of course you can already also do so by creating a new Git. Well, let me just show you how that looks. If you have enabled Finder to show hidden files, then you can see this Git here. If not, you will only see these two, well, the folder and the Xcode project, but you can add this Git later on. Go ahead and take a look at the YouTube series where I go in depth into GitHub. I will not cover this today because it's too much to see for one video. Okay, now next up, once you have all of this set up, go ahead and let's create a new branch, because what we want to do is this is okay, but we want to test some new things. So go ahead and right click on the master and create a branch from a master. Now I will just type in here and make sure you don't have any spaces in there or any special characters. So go ahead and click on create, and as you can see, we are inside our testing GitHub current branch. So if you go and let's see, add inside here view controller, let's change the view's background color equals dot red. Okay, and let's build and let's select first of all our iPhone 10 simulator and build and run with Command R, our keyboard shortcut. And now we should have a red background. Let's wait for it to launch. And then, as you can see here, we have our red view. Now this is built upon our branch. Let me just go there, and this is said this is testing and current branch. Now let's go to source control and let's commit this. Now we are committing, first of all, we are creating a screenshot of our project on our Mac at first. Now if you want to push to remote, and of course as you can see here, it, let me just check, it says origin. We are pushing it up to the cloud, to the origin testing GitHub branch, and we are creating it, and that is fine. Yeah, one thing, as you can see here, we can enter a commit message, and we need to enter a commit message, basically what you did. And you should be more explicit than this one. Of course, when you know what you are working on, you can add a more explicit comment here. So let's push on commit one file and push. So we are committing to our changes. We are saving it onto our desktop, well, on my computer, and then we are pushing it up to GitHub. Now, let's just go to our Google Chrome and let's see how that looks in our repository. Okay, as you can see, it already shows us that testing GitHub less than a minute ago was pushed, and it kind of says compare and pull request. You can do that inside this dashboard, but for now let's just see how we are as of branches. As you can see here, we have testing GitHub, and we have changed this to testing GitHub, and as you can see here, we have first changes. And now let's go back to Xcode and see that in the master branch there isn't this statement view background color dot red. Okay, let's go back to master. Okay, and let's go to select our view controller here, and maybe I just need to double click on it. No, let's change. So right click and check out. Okay, let's check out, and as you can see, we are inside our current branch. It is the master, and now if we go to our view controller, the background color statement has been removed, of course, because we have added that inside our branch. Now if you are okay with these changes, then we can merge that branch into a master, and of course we can merge branches into other branches, but that is a whole other topic. For now, let's go back and let's check out this testing GitHub branch, and then let's merge it. Yes, let's select, let's right click on master and merge master into testing GitHub. No, merge testing GitHub into master. So let's select that. Let's click on the merge. And you can also take a look at what is going on there, what we are changing, and let's merge. Okay, and now let's take a look at our view controller. And as you can see, we are also already in the master, and we have our view.background equals dot red light inside our master. Now, what else can we do? Well, first of all, we can commit these changes. Yep, we have already done that because there are no changes. Okay, that is fine. And okay, what else can we do here? Well, we can simply delete. So let's delete our testing GitHub branch. So let's delete this, and we are ready. Okay, and that is it for the basics of GitHub and using GitHub. If you want a more in-depth tutorial, go ahead and check out my YouTube series. It's a whole episode list. It's a playlist on YouTube, so go ahead and check that out. And that is it for today. I really hope that you have created your GitHub account and you have pushed your first project up to that GitHub account. I will see you in the next lesson in ASD. Keep up the good work. Good stuff. Now, if you want to see more of this video and want to boost your app business, go ahead and take a look at my 30 days challenge, App Store Domination. Go ahead and click the link down below and I will see you inside ASD, App Store Domination. Let's get to work.